standard, ale niczego będą występowali w Chicago, także to jest taka, dla mnie to jest w ogóle strasznie
wspaniałe. So actually those two pianists that were performing in the movie, Randall Corson and Janusz Olejniczak, will be performing in Chicago as a part of the this weekend's Chopin in the City performances. So if you're really thrilled with those two pianists, look it up and you can listen to them live in Chicago, I think tomorrow and Saturday, Friday and Saturday. Saturday and Sunday. And Grazyna may be able to tell more about exact location and times.
Jeśli chodzi o kontakty, to wiem, że Grazyna wcześniej też próbowała zaprosić Randala, więc to był jeden kontakt. Drugi kontakt to była taka pani, która przez moment tutaj tylko występuje. I właściwie, ale to jest tak maleńka wyspa, że w momencie, kiedy ja tam pojechałam, to właściwie kilka dni znałam wszystkich już.
So, to establish the contacts was very quite easy on the island, because it's a small island. And, you know, with the topic at hand, you know, within a few days, I was able to kind of get to know all the people interested and relevant to the story. Any questions from the audience? The question was about the Polish pianist Janusz Olejniczak. When did he win the top prize at the Chopin's International Competition in Warsaw? And the answer was 1970.
Yeah.
So the question I'll say, so was the idea for the concert that was portrayed at the end of the show, at the end of the movie, was that an idea brought in by the movie director, or was it kind of a locally grown initiative by Randall?
To był mój pomysł, ponieważ musiałam w jakiś sposób opowiedzieć tę historię, a w momencie, kiedy w lipcu tam pojechałam i zobaczyłam, że tak naprawdę ta sytuacja z Chopinem, jego znajomością tam, jego graniem jest dużo bardziej skomplikowana, niż by się wydawało. I te trzy rodziny, bo tam jest rodzina Palmów, Korsenów i Baskalionów, ta pani, która ma ten piękny dom z tym malarstwem, to jej rodzice malowali. Są trzy takie duże rodziny muzyczne i one są dość skłócone. One zresztą były skłócone też ze mną na początku, ponieważ były do mnie tak jakby zamknięte, dlatego że ta książka pod tytułem Dlaczego 11 Antylczyków skręczało przed sercem Chopina w jakimś sensie ich obraziła, bo to napisał Jan Brokan, czyli Holender, czyli właściwie Holendrzy ich kolonizowali przez wiele lat i oni tam się czuli urażeni, nie bardzo tą książkę akceptowali. I kiedy ja przyjechałam mówiąc o tej książce, to oni się natychmiast zamknęli, to trwało 1-2 dni, ponieważ ja ich przekonałam, że mi chodzi o coś innego niż takie zamknięcie w książce jakiejś historii pana, który tutaj przyjeżdża i myśli, że wszystko na ten temat wie, więc powiedziałam, że po prostu ja chcę im oddać głos.
So the idea about the cancer came from Agnieszka. She wanted to kind of have some way to present the complexity of Chopin's presence and influence on the music of Curacao and the whole story. So she came to know three main families that are presented here in the movie. So Randall, Corson family, Palm family, and
Baskalion,
which were involved in that, carrying on that tradition and developing that tradition on local culture. And unfortunately, all three families sort of historically were in disagreement, were quarreling with each other, so they were not maybe willing to cooperate on the making of the movie. They saw the book, the message of the book, and author of the book, which we mentioned in the beginning, about the 11 Antillians dancing in front of the Chopin's kneeling in front of Chopin's heart. As a sort of a colonizer story. So there's another layer here. And I guess, as a side note for me, I'm amazed with how many layers of stories and issues that movie packs into 1 hour. I'm just thrilled, but yeah, it's awesome. Anyway, so those initially those families were not really willing to cooperate with the project brought in by Agnieszka. And what finally convinced them to work with you?
Myślę, że taka sytuacja, w której właśnie im powiedziałam, że chcę im oddać głos i co więcej, chciałabym, żeby był to koncert, który ich pogodzi. Co rzeczywiście się stało, dlatego że jest ta scena na przykład u okulisty, to jest Steven Palm, i przychodzi do niego Korsen i on mu daje nuty.
So the concert actually ended up becoming a catalyst event in bringing those three families together and reuniting them. One of the scenes when Randall Corson comes to the optometrist, who is one of the family members of the Palm family. You know, this is kind of one of the signs of the. Growing cooperation and resolution of the conflict between those families, where they decided to kind of share their heritage and, you know, whatever treasures they had hidden in their archive, family archives, you know, share them between all three families.
Tak właśnie było. I generalnie problem polegał na tym, jak to wszystko opowiedzieć, dlatego że ja byłam dość przytłoczona ilością jakby materiału, który w ogóle na tą godzinę mogłam nakręcić. To znaczy nie wiedziałam w ogóle, w jaki sposób do tego podejść, ponieważ w momencie, kiedy zaczęłam szukać tych śladów Chopina tam, to tak naprawdę odkryłam dużo, dużo, dużo więcej. Przede wszystkim odkryłam potwornie skomplikowaną i bolesną historię tej wyspy.
So I was overwhelmed, as I was doing the research and filming, talking to people, I was really overwhelmed by the amount of material I came across, amount of stories, and you know, also I discovered the very painful and complicated history of the island. So I was trying to figure out how I can present it in 1 hour, you know, that was kind of dedicated to that documentary.
I postanowiłam jakby nie kolonizować ich Chopinem ponownie, to znaczy zrobić koncert, w którym będzie Chopin oczywiście, ale będzie, specjalnie używam tego słowa, ale także będzie ich muzyka i nie ta muzyka, która jest przerobiona z Chopina, która jak wiemy z filmu była czasem jakby po prostu tak oni zmuszani, czarni, zmuszani do grania na tych fortepianach. Tylko postanowiła właśnie nie kolonizować, czyli postawić na równo ich własną muzykę rdzenną, czyli właśnie tambu z Chopinem. I w momencie, no tak.
So as the movie developed, I decided to present it not as a kind of a, their local folklore, folk music and Chopin's music kind of on a more equal level. And do not use my Chopin's project to colonize them again culturally, because you know of that painful story where sometimes that music of European descendants was forced upon the local population.
Tak, i stąd się właściwie narodził taki prawdziwy link pomiędzy Chopinem a muzyką karaibską, kurasauską. Czyli tak naprawdę sens tego, co dla Chopina znaczyła jego muzyka w momencie, kiedy był na emigracji i co dla kreolskiej po prostu ludności znaczyło tambu, czyli tak naprawdę wyzwolenie swojej duszy z czegoś, czego nie mogli znieść.
So as a result, it's kind of it brought it the more connection more cultural connection, historical connection between those musical traditions from Chopin, what really Chopin's music meant, you know, in terms of the historical history of Poland and what tambu music meant in terms of history of that music by a local population. Any other questions? All right, so I guess we'll introduce Grazyna Auguscik and Paul Bedal. Thank you very much. Sorry, I jumped the gun. So we'll do a 15-minute break, and musicians will set up, and after that we'll have the concert by Grazyna Auguscik and Paul Bedal interpreting Chopin's music in the jazz style. So come back in 15 minutes. Thank you very much.
Can we get some applause for Simon for the phenomenal translation?
Thank you. By the way, Grazyna brought in some of her CDs there at the front door if you're interested in their music. right, I think we're going to start the second part of the show. And I would like to introduce Grazyna Auguscik and Paul Bedal from Chicago. And one more time, I would like to thank Cafe Coda for hosting this event. Also, UW-Madison Polish Student Association for sponsoring and support. Without further ado, this is Grazyna Auguscik and Paul Bedal.
Thank you very much. Thank you for waiting for us. We actually gonna land soon in like 20 minutes, so that our plane was delayed for 3.5 hours. So we decided to drive here. So great to be here. Wonderful to finally get to the place. I hear about this place a lot. So thank you to have us here. Thank you, Szymon, to introduce us to Madison audience. I don't have a chance to be here often, but I hope I will come here again. So hope you enjoyed the movie. Did you? I like it too. Actually, Agnieszka is not here, but you know the story about the movie. She told you or not? Yes? She did? Okay, so I don't gonna repeat because it's boring after all. So thank you. We're gonna present some music of Frederic Chopin. As you hear, I actually started the festival 5 years ago, Chopin in the City. And the festival happened every year in February, but I think I'm going to move to October. And I hope we will be soon also, the part of the festival in Madison. We have a fantastic concert this coming Sunday. Janusz Olejniczak is coming to Chicago. If you are interested, it's the only opportunity to see him. He has only one concert here in the United States. If you're not familiar with Janusz Olejniczak, he's one of the most important Chopin interpreter. Thank you. But he's marvelous. It's my honor to have him as a guest and part of the festival. As I told you, more information you can find on the website chopinindecity.com. So right now, we're gonna stay with the Chopin, but we play Chopin in not the usual way. We're just gonna use some of his tune and we're gonna do in jazz style. So Paul Bedal and Etude B minor. Thank you. Thank you. So it was the etude, a B minor, of course, the part of the etude. And now we're going to move to beautiful nocturne. I really love Chopin's nocturne. This is nocturne in a E minor, sorry.
La tour.
Thank you. Thank you very much. A little more in my monitor, just a slide. So we have right now Prelude, or maybe Lezumatulu. It's a Polish folk tune. You know, the Chopin, most of his work was based on folk music. The folk music is, that's always the inspiration for a lot of composers around the world. And I adapt one of the famous folk song, Matulu Moya. It's about the, you know, mother, daughter. Most people speak probably Polish, but I will just tell the short story about the tune. The mother arranged the husband for the daughter, but she was very unhappy, and she said that her beauty will disappear after she get married. Well, because, you know, she didn't love the boy. That's the probably reason. But well, when in the old days, when the women got married, they had a lot of work around the house, so they didn't think about their beauty anymore. Matulu Moya. She's begging the mother to, you know, to don't push her to marry. Do 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 Thank you. It's a great piano.
Yeah.
How do you like Paul the piano?
I like it.
He played completely different than yesterday. We played yesterday in Houston, so we are traveling since 9 in the morning. So finally, that's why we took a fly actually, but because the fly was canceled, so decided to come here. So we couldn't cancel the concert in this place. So I like it. It's a place. The piano, yeah. Yeah, you sound great, Paul. Prelude C minor. Do We didn't plan this tune, but the piano is beautiful. So let's play Sonata G minor. This is actually the tune written for cello and piano. So I'm a cello. Thank you. Isn't it a beautiful tune? I hope I didn't mess up the cello part, but it's hard. It's the hardest repertory for me to sing the Chopin pieces. I sing all piano music. He wrote some tune, some songs, but I'm not a big fan of his songs. I love the piano music, and it's a very challenging because all the tunes are in original keys, but I love it. Chopin's music, it's one of the best. Who actually doesn't love Chopin's music? Somebody probably, maybe my singing is not exactly like the music he wrote, but I'm pretty sure that he was a very good jazz player. He improvised all his life. And actually his compositions are that's probably one of the thousands of versions of all the tunes, so he had to make money. That's like we are playing music, but it's my passion, and that's why we travel all day to get here. Mazurkas.
Do 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 do
Something special. One of my favorite tunes, slow tune. I love slow tunes. Minor slow. I'm Polish, so it's in my blood. Triptych number 2, written by Witold Lutosławski. Beautiful piece.
Thank you. serce. Wiedziałoś to przecie moje serce, moje serce.
Thank you very much. There was a, also a folk tune. Witold Lutosławski had a different period of his work, compositions. Some parts of his work was based on Polish folk music. It was still 1954. And he actually didn't like that, the period. I don't know why, but I think the piece is beautiful. And then he changed his style. He was a contemporary classical musician, incredible. But this piece is about also drama, the women who is who find out that his but her boyfriend has a different lover. He noticed because he turned to her drinking with her, with the girlfriend, another girlfriend, lover, and she was very sad, and they didn't talk about it. He didn't tell her, but her heart knew that he is in love with somebody else. It's a drama, it's a woman drama, you see. Be careful with whom you drink. Yes. So thank you so much for being here tonight, and I know it's late, so we're gonna do the most famous prelude E minor in our way.
Paul Bedal, Grazyna Auguscik, Agnieszka Lipiec-Wroblewska, thank you, Szymon Woźniczka. Thank you all for coming. Thank you very, very much, Hanach. Thank you.
Bravo.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Paul. Thank you. It's so much. I really appreciate it. Wasn't that great, ladies and gentlemen? This is so special for us that we have this this cross-culturalization of jazz and this great music of Chopin. And listen, hey everybody, check out, listen up, hold on a second. Jesus, I gotta say something here. Because I tell you, I was actually really moved by this because I think that somehow I was listening to this music and I'm thinking that there might be some real connection in your sense of improvisation and what is happening now. And so I know is this your first time here?
Yes.
Paul, this is your second time here.
Second, yeah.
So you should know what's about to happen. Right? Everybody in here. How many people are here for the first time? Okay, put your hands down because it's too many of you all. Now, this sister here, I'm just so moved. And what is so wonderful is I can't even pronounce her name.
Grazyna.
Grazyna. Huh? Auguscik. Did that work? Now, Grazyna, I know we've just been introduced, but I want you to know that I believe that your voice is somewhere between cello and soprano saxophone.
Believe or not, cello is my favorite instrument and the soprano saxophone is my favorite instrument.
Grazyna,
so you see?
I know we've only been introduced, but I'm a soprano saxophone player.
You see?
Yes. And I can't allow you to leave mm-hmm. without your permission to improvise with you.
Yes.
On soprano saxophone.
On soprano, I can't. I can't.
Just be cool. It's going to happen. Is it okay? Shimon,
I don't play saxophone.
Come here and speak Polish for about 3 minutes while I warm up.
Let's do it.
So I hope that next time
some
when Grazyna,
some blues or whatever.
Okay, yeah, whale.
Are you going to sing Polish for 3 minutes when he warms up?
You can say Polish, whatever okay. you want. I can say Polish.
How about this famous Mazurek Dąbrowskiego?
No, not now. No, come on. No. No, he's going to bring something. I don't know. Just play some jazz. Do anything together, so.
You give me a tonal center, Paul, and I'm going to listen to this wonderful voice and play along.
We play
with it,
some.
And I promise to stay
some
out
some
of the
some
way. Okay. Give me an
what
A. Can I just
play?
Have an A? Because I haven't had an A today.
Thank you. I'm gonna surprise you. I'm gonna go do a Bud Powell whale. Do you know? Whale? Okay, fine. So we'll see.
Paul's my favorite piano player from now on.
Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.